Hi everybody, today is February 9th, 2013. U.S. halts drilling on Gulf wells with flawed bolts. Deepwater oil exploration has been disrupted from the Gulf of Mexico to Brazil by the discovery of faulty bolts used in safety equipment less than 3 years after the worst ever U.S. maritime crude spill. Energy explorers such as Chevron Corp, Royal Dutch Shell, and Transocean Ltd. said they have been directed by the U.S. regulator to suspend work aboard rigs that employ General Electric Company devices connecting drilling tubes to safety gear and the seafloor. The equipment must be retrieved so defective bolts can be replaced, the U.S. Bureau of Safety and Environmental Enforcement said in an alert issued on January 29th. Installing new bolts and resuming drilling may take as long as 3 weeks for each rig, Credit Suisse Group AG said. For oil companies paying upward to $600,000 a day to rent the most sophisticated deepwater vessels and another $500,000 a day to staff and supply each of them, the delays may be significant, said Craig Pryrog, director of the University of Houston's Global Energy Management Institute. This certainly will be costly for the industry, Pryrog said in a telephone interview yesterday. This is a result of increasing government scrutiny of deep water activities. The question is, will the increased cost be so onerous that they discourage some companies from searching the deep ocean for crude? Boy, wouldn't that be nice. Lower earnings from the Gulf may be consequence for the service companies due to potential for longer downtime than expected, Bill Herbert, an analysis that Simon & Company in Houston wrote today in a note to investors. Oh, I bet you Bush and Cheney are probably all upset about that, aren't they? Oh, poor babies. GE bolt revelations yesterday galvanized the market as Macondo's scar tissue sensitivity remains acute, he wrote. Think of this as a modest tropical storm, albeit in January. The defect was discovered last month after a leak of drilling fluid was linked to bolts that failed because of the stress corrosion, according to the January 29th alert. The regulator didn't identify the owner of the rig or which oil company was leasing it. GE declined to identify the manufacturer of the bolts. Nations with acute offshore crude exploration have been alerted to the bolts' defect, said Sean Gannon, a spokesman for the field Connecticut-based GE. In the Gulf of Mexico, 24 of the 83 rigs actively drilling wells at the time of the alert carry connections that may have flawed bolts, the Bureau said. Of those, 6 rigs have so far been cleared to return to drilling operations. Everyone in the industry is aware of this, Gannon said in an interview yesterday. We've contacted every customer, global regulators. There's a whole overlapping set of layers where active drilling rigs in particular have been appraised, and they're on top of it. About 30 to 40 GE customers are potentially affected, Gannon said in an email. Anadarko Petroleum Corporation, APC, the second largest U.S. independent oil and natural gas producer by market value, said it will be swapping out bolts at its Phobias well and a Caesar Tonga development well. We will be able to replace the bolt at the next available stopping point with minimal downtime and no impacts on production, John Christensen, a spokesman, said today in an email. Deepwater oil exploration involves extending steel tubes from floating rigs more than a mile to the seafloor and inserting a drill bit through the tube to carve a hole into the earth. 5-story stacks of valves and pressure control gear, known as blowout preventers, or BOP, are planted atop the well to snuff out unpredictable surges of gas and crude that pose a danger to rig crews on the surface. It was just such a surge that exploded onto the deck of Transocean's Deepwater Horizon in April 2010, killing 11 workers, injuring 17, and triggering an 87-day oil spill that followed thousands of square miles and shut much of the Gulf to fishing and exploration for months. The $365 million rig that sank during the disaster still rests on the seafloor. He goes on to say that oil production from wells in federal waters of the Gulf account for 20% of total U.S. crude output as of the end of November, according to Energy Information Administration. The region produced about 7% of the nation's gas. The defective bolts are part of a GE product known as a H4 connector, an 18.75-inch clamp that attaches to blowout preventers to the well below it and to the pipes that lead to the rig on the surface. Transocean has the greatest exposure with 55 of its rigs around the world outfitted with GE connectors, including a dozen in the Gulf of Mexico. It also says that the Deepwater Horizon catastrophe prompted U.S. regulators to increase scrutiny and testing of subsea equipment and call for upgrades. BOP costs about $45 million and weighs as much as 400 tons. Some rig operators have begun using multiple BOPs at a drilling site to speed the inspection process and bolster safety. And I'll give you a link if you want to read more. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.